Hi everyone, welcome back to the Digital Outreach Series for the Aiken County Historical Museum. My name's Lauren.
I'm Leah.
And you are watching Coffee
and Tea
with the county. So we are in the Entertainers exhibit, which is up on the second floor of the museum. It's a little bit towards the back hallway, and this actually, back in the day when we were at Banksia in 1931 as a private residence, this most likely would have been a governess's room to the granddaughters who visited here. So we are sitting in a somebody's old bedroom, which is kind of cool. So you just get to know a little bit of the history of the room and the space. But today, of course, it houses the Entertainers exhibit. And that's what we're here to talk to y'all about.
I love this exhibit and didn't know how much I loved this exhibit until I came in here today. As I have said before in some of our other videos, this is my favorite part, is being able to get to know these exhibits better. And of course, I have come in here and I have read some panels and I've read some labels and looked over some things and I thought, oh wow, you know, Aiken County, pretty cool. We've got some famous folks.
Famous,
you know?
Names, yeah.
Yeah, but y'all, Aiken County is cool.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't know.
Certifiable. We're good.
Certified. Truly.
Yeah.
Truly.
Yeah.
I didn't know. And I work here. Shame. Shame on me. So I'm just walking around looking at, because normally what we do when we do a coffee and tea, mm-hmm. normally what we do is we walk around and we pick an artifact. And we say, this is our favorite artifact in the exhibit. Mm-hmm. But in here, well, Lauren won't let me play with anything.
No, sorry. The collections manager, I mean, just won't let you do it.
So, yeah,
no playing with the artifacts.
No playing with that. And I really love this. Niles Borup right behind me. He has a golden record, but below it, a golden cassette.
So cool.
That is so cool.
For us 80s kids.
Right. Kids at home. You might want to look up what cassette means.
Or ask your parents what a remix means.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right. So it was kind of hard to choose what our favorite mm-hmm. element of the exhibit was. So I just went with one of the composers, one of the songwriters that is in here.
And that's the fascinating thing about our Entertainers exhibit is we have songwriters, we have composers, we have performers in the theater and the arts. I mean, just a lot of talented folks have come out of Aiken County and made it to the national scene. And that's a lot of what we celebrate in this room is those who have moved their careers to the national level and just, you know, made it big, you mm-hmm. know? So it's really neat to see those stories and those lives. You know, they may not have grown up in Aiken County, or they may have, or they might have moved here later in life or lived here just partially when they were younger. But just the amount of names that you see come out of our area, it's just fascinating.
It really is absolutely stunning how many... How many people, how many names, how many songs?
Well, that's just it. It's so impressive, their musical resumes. I mean, Niles Borup behind me has been, you know, Songwriter of the Year several times. You're going to be talking about Stuart Harris, who's been a magnificent composer, too. And then, of course, off to the side, you can't see her, but we've got Flo Carter, a panel about her, and she's just a firecracker of a woman. I've seen her perform multiple times, and you can see her too. You just have to look out for when you see her performing in the CSRA. But she's just a wonderful woman, a great performer, and she, of course, has worked with Jim Nabors. And again, kids out there, if you don't know who Jim Nabors is, just watch Mayberry, and you'll see him as Gomer Pyle. And she also worked with Brenda Lee. And Brenda Lee had that classic Christmas song, Rocking Around the Christmas Tree. So, which if you've ever watched Home Alone, you have heard it.
Oh, don't get me started. I will sing.
Yeah. And of course, we're dating ourselves again. Yeah,
yes.
80s and 90s kids. But anyways, great, fascinating people in this room to learn about. Mm-hmm. But Leah, do you want to start off with your favorite?
Well, y'all, could not believe it. Shocked when I came in here and read this. Well, one of the first things that I want to tell you that I read that I was shocked about is about Minnie Pearl. Now, if you've gone through the other videos and you're caught up, thank you.
You're a true fan.
You are.
Yeah.
If you're not, scroll back.
Yeah.
Go back to the Business Merchants of Aiken exhibit, mm-hmm. or County and Tea, or Coffee and Tea, rather. And I will tell you, so you know, I drink tea on the county's dime every day. But if you go down there, you will see that exhibit. You will see on that video where I talk about Miss Minnie Pearl. And Ola Hitt, and if you were an Aikenite, you know the name, Miss Ola Hitt.
Yeah.
You know who she is and what a mover and shaker she was.
Oh, yeah.
Or maybe you've driven down Ola Hitt Lane.
Yeah, it's got a street named after her. Mm-hmm. That's pretty cool.
But she worked at Swarovski's department store when Miss Sarah Ophelia Colley came in and bought that famous hat with the price tag still dangling. And she remembers that day, and she was there at Swarovski's the day Minnie Pearl was born.
That's so awesome. Right, history in the making. Yeah, in downtown Aiken.
Just fascinating.
Yeah.
So that's the first thing I learned when I came in. Then I walk over here to Stuart Harris's exhibit panel, and whoa, did he blow me away. So I'm going to show you this, because this is a huge deal anyway. This is where he was inducted into the South Carolina Hall of Fame. Shocking, because I take this off, right? And I turn it around. Okay. And I'm just kind of looking, and I'm like, oh, look, this guy's from the same county I'm from. Da, 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 da. And then I come down here, Vanna White. What?
Another South Carolina girl.
Oh, love
yeah,
it.
Amazing.
So this is what comes from getting to know your exhibits, folks. So this is Stuart Harris, and Stuart Harris wrote, well, 9 number one hits so far. And he had, you know, hit after hit after hit. Now, dating ourselves again, he wrote the theme song for America's Funniest Home Videos.
One of my favorite shows. I used to love waiting for that show to come on and seeing all the hilarity. And this is back when they put him on video, on, because, you know, VHS.
Literal VHS.
Yes.
Another term for you to look up, children.
Exactly. Nothing was digital. It was all analog back then.
Yes. So. But Stuart, I thought he was fascinating, and he wrote a Winona song. I promised myself that I wasn't going to sing it. I wanted to so bad. Stay tuned.
Yes.
Maybe you'll get another post.
That's
with me just
bonus
rocking
bonus
out to Winona.
Yeah.
I better stop.
Yeah.
How about you, Lauren?
Sure. So going around the exhibit, the person that I've picked to talk about is Bubber Miley. And Bubber Miley was born in the Aiken area, I believe more towards the Montmorency-Windsor side, but correct me if I'm wrong, public. And he was born in 1903. He moved out of the area at the age of, let's see, 1918. At age 15, he joined the Navy. Wow. And served as a band member for 18 months.
Wow.
So really cool. I think he only lived here in the area for about 6 years, but then he moved to New York City and he began performing with a cornet. And I always get the trombone, the cornet. I'm not that good with musical instruments and identification, but I know it's an instrument that was similar to a trumpet and things like that. But he performed with Duke Ellington. And Duke Ellington is a well-known jazz musician, just famous band leader from back in the day. And he and Bubber Miley performed together at the Cotton Club in New York City. That's where they made their kind of landmark debut. Now, unfortunately, Bubber Miley passed away at a very young age. He was only 29 years old. Mm. I know. And he passed away from tuberculosis, which is something, thank goodness, I know that we don't have to worry about too much nowadays in America. But back then, in the 1800s and the early 1900s, it really was something to be concerned about.
And for, you know, for him to play a wind instrument,
yes,
and his lungs to be gone, to just be so affected.
I know. And tuberculosis is normally a disease you suffer from years. And so the fact that he was able to perform, to make it to the national stage like that, and become famously associated with one of the most famous jazz musicians of the era, and then die tragically so young of a disease that takes away your lungs. I mean, it's just heartbreaking.
Mm-hmm.
But we do have one of his records in our collection, which is really neat. And so as we revamp our exhibits and as we make them more technologically advanced, we hope to be able to allow y'all to come into this room and press different interactives, once interactives are allowed, and experience the music of our musicians in this area, because it's just amazing what they've created as artists, you know?
Absolutely.
So that's my pick, Bubber Miley of Aiken. Nice. So, yeah, fun times. Well, we hope y'all have enjoyed this talk here up in our entertainers exhibit. And again, it's just a taste of how many talented musicians, performers we have coming from our area. And we hope that you will come enjoy the exhibit for yourself.
Have a good weekend.
Yep. Bye, y'all.